Hello, Muckers. Just a quick one on a herringbone shout out as a thank you for everyone's support recently. It's a new one in that wild deck, but it's obviously not a new one that Jeff has told us, but I was doing an 18 befriending a little while back, and I was setting out, and we're setting out for even cuts. Now, I'm trying to do a video where I've done my centre line, I've done my reference line on it, and I'm getting it all down, I'm getting it ready to set up. And then Jeff's come up with this other idea now, and it's how we've always done ours, but I've just never knew the reason behind it. We've always done our herringbones going up the side of it, not following the centre bit. But what he done when we was on there to work out to get the even cuts is what I'm about to show now, and it is so simple. It raises all the complication for it. Now, I went up to Bash's trade day the other Friday, and now this one worked with Jeff on 18 to 3, but I was with Ross and that, and we've done it with an 18 to 4, and it worked. I've been speaking to Paddy about it, and he's seen the sense in it. But what I've got here is a Van Gogh one we've cut down, so it's an unorthodox pattern. You've got a 7 by 21, and I'm just going to try and test the thing just to show you like this little simple way of doing it to get even cuts either side. So, to start off, we've got an area here that I've just mapped out. It's like, it's only 2 metres across. So we're just gonna set it out as normal and test the old theory that Jeff's got. So I'll just make a Christmas tree out, as you would, you know, if you were gonna be sitting out here anyway. I'll just wait a little one for it. So, regardless of size of plank, this, I'm hoping, well, it has worked on everything so far. So, this will be your first, you know, your herringbone pattern or whatever you want to call it, that you'll be fitting, you'll be setting out. Oh, I've left it down with that. Anyway, what you've done, now, bear in mind, I've set out on my middle line, I've done all my fancy stuff, and this is what you've done for us to solve. You just put a plank one side. Nah, it's too dopey. Measured across. So we've got 88 centimetres across, okay? Half of 88, 44. So what I'm doing now, I'm going to pin the centre line down on this. And then what I'm going to do afterwards, I'm going to mark a line 44 centimetres off to the left of the centre line. And instead of lining up my herringbone and racking it up, trying to follow this centre line and ref line to the top, what we're going to do is just butt it off of this line, go all the way to the thing, and we're just going to see if it does an equal cut either side, to see if it is. Because otherwise, you know, it just breaks down all the bollocks that you've got to do with all the other ones, if it works with one and all the other. So, a little bit of music, you fast forward a bit, as me, the old Governor Paul.
Yeah.
I'm going to set this one out, so. Not visible in that lot. What we've got here is a centre line, and then I've done a line 44 centimetres, which is half that distance across there. So we're just going to put the sliders on the 44, the line. We're going to bring our pattern over. Sorry, Chief. Get that on the line there. You know, I'm going to feed a few more into it. And we're just going to check what the cuts are. Here's going to be the money shot for us to just test our theories. And we're going to be cut brilliant, okay? So, in theory, that's going to be our cut. I don't know if you can see it, guys. It's not a brilliant cut, is it? But the way I just want to quickly check if it is going to be equal cuts both sides. Although not millimeter perfect there, because that one's straight out, but you're looking at that as being... It doesn't even matter if you're not dead on perfect, but if you're looking at that way, that is a simpler way to set out any bloody herringbone. Isn't it? So you just divide it by two, and then butt them all off a straight line. So what we're doing now, we're gonna stick all these bits now, then we're gonna go around the edges, doing some fitting with the mortar boards. Obviously not the fluorescent ones though.
Oh yeah. Yeah. It's all about you. One time,
I'ma say it's all about you.
For the bitches that think it's all about you.
It's all about you. Drew Allen in the house with my boy Pizknock. You know
it's
what I'm saying?
It's all about you.
Yeah, I'ma say it's all about you, but you're not lying now. Yeah, yeah.
You probably took it as the last trick. Wanna laugh at how I got my ass caught up with this bad bitch? Thinking I had her, but she had me in the long run. It's just my luck. I'm stuck with fucking with the wrong one. Why
the seasons? Use in a minute. Here's my new wolf. Oh, fuck me, that is smooth. Right, comments on the wolf roller. Fucking smooth. Feel that. Thanks, Basha, that's fucking mustard.
They telling me, rush out of jail like hell for a black celebrity. So that's the reason why I call, and maybe you win. Fantasies of a sweating, can I hit it? Addicted to the things you do, it's still true. What I'm saying, boo, is this is all about you.
Every other city we